So in this particular application, what we have here is a dense grade, so an ASTM 2940D base. That's your hard pack gravel. So in this particular case, I'm gonna be using my spike flange. So hitting the spikes in on our 60 degree opposing angles, stitching technology. People ask as far as what we do with the number 8 stone. Number 8 stone obviously kind of undermines when we cut it away. And with our sand plow, we cut about half of that out, so about a half inch of our 1 inch setting bed. That way we don't get too much undermining underneath our border stone. And then what we'll do is we'll snip the edging. We'll get the edging up tight, and we're just gonna kind of shake it down into that number 8 stone and almost tilt the edging into the border stone. That way there, it's gonna keep the top bend here nice and tight against the paver to keep that from having lateral shift. So I wanna cut minimal amounts. So I'm gonna try at this point, I'll cut every other one. Like I said, it's gonna give it the strength when it's rigid. I can pre-bend this a little bit. It's a nice part about the aluminum. You can pre-bend it and you're not gonna get that boomeranging where it's gonna snap back. And then when I pull it tight, as you can see, it's gonna come right tight to me. And this is what I'm talking about as far as that little bit of shaking down in. I'm not talking a lot, just a little bit so that my edge of my aluminum stays nice and tight here. So the preferred option, hitting it in with the Quickie hammer bit. This goes into an SDS Max hammer. This is milled out of one solid piece of steel. It's heat treated, it's tempered, hardened, and then it's zinc coated. So a real quick, efficient way for hitting your spikes in. And again, I highly recommend you're gonna stand on your base, skip your two holes, hold your toe into it. That's all you're gonna do. Slide that down, again, skip two holes. Make sure we're nice and tight.